Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to discuss another problem, but before going forward, if you have not liked the video, please like it. Subscribe to my channel because we solve awesome problems daily and I don't want you to miss any problem. So also hit the bell icon so that you get notified when I post a new video. So without any further ado, let's get started. Problem is delete operation for two strings. So we'll see right from the beginning how to approach the problem and how to dry run. So let's see. So in this problem we are given two strings, word1 and word2. Return the minimum number of steps required to make word1 and word2 same. So two strings are given, we need to make them same. And what we can do in one step, we can delete exactly one character from either of the string. So in each step, like in one step, we can delete a character from any one of the string. Either we can delete a character from this string or we can delete a character from this string in one step. We need to return the minimum number of steps so that we can make them equal. Okay. For example, see here. These two are strings, right? So let's take C and eat. So we have C and we have eat. So now we need to make them equal, right? And that too we need to do in minimum number of steps. And in one step, what you can do? Delete one character. So when you will delete one character, that will count as one step. Now see guys, if I have to make them equal only, right? We need to make them equal. If I have to make them equal only, what I can do? I can just remove all the characters from this string. It will become equal. I will remove all the characters from this string. This will also become equal. Empty. Right? This will become empty. This will become empty. So both are empty. So they are equal. So this is one way. But in this way, what I am doing is I am deleting all the characters. Right? So how many steps? Let's say there are m characters in this string and n characters in this string. So m plus n will be the number of steps. Why? Because in each step you are deleting one character, right? So this is one step, this is one step, this is one step, one step, one step, one step. Obviously this is could be an answer, but this will not be the correct answer. Why? Because we need to find the minimum number of steps. This is not the minimum value. This is obviously the maximum value, right? So this is not the correct approach. What we can do, let's see once again. Just try to think what could be another way. So we have C. And we have eat. Okay. So what we can do is, C. We need to make them equal in minimum number of steps, right? So if we need to have minimum number of steps, we need to delete, we need to remove minimum characters. We need to try to remove minimum characters, because if we remove a character, that will count as one step. So if we want minimum steps, we should remove minimum elements. So we should only remove those elements which are not same in both strings. Do you agree on this? Not same in both strings. For example, here S is not same, T is not same, EA and EA are same. Alright, so what we can do is we can, this is not the same, this character is not in this string and this character is not in this string. So we can remove those. So if I remove S, that will be one step, and then if I remove T, that will be one step. So then after removal, this will become EA, T, and this will become EA, T will be removed from the end. So EA, EA, these will be equal. So how many steps? Two steps. So now you might be thinking that it's very simple. What we can do is we can just simply find out how many characters are not same. Characters are not same. But this approach, right, will not work every time. For example, let's say we have this let's tweak this test case a bit. So instead of like this, I'm taking ESA and this is eat. Okay. Now, see, what you might, so see guys, what we can do is, just try to think what, see, over here, there are two ways we can do. The one approach which we discussed right now was that we will find out the different characters, but that won't work every time. Okay. So over here, see, now this E and A, E and A, right? These are same characters, right? These are characters which are present in both the string, right? So what we can do is, like, let's say, let me just change this test case to AE, something like this. Okay. Now, what you will do? See, now what you will do? Now you will understand why we cannot use the above approach. Now, what you will do according to above approach, that you will see, okay, which characters are different. S is different, so one step. T is different, so one step. So two steps are needed to make these strings equal. But is that so? See, if you remove S, what this will become? EA. And if you remove T, what it will become? AE. Right? So these are not equal. We cannot rearrange the characters, right? We can only remove the character. So the approach, this approach which we thought, right, that we will find out how many different characters are there, then that many number of steps will be required. That approach is not correct. Why? Because of this test case, you can see. So now, how we can think of another approach, right? So let's see that. So test case was EAT, NSEA. Okay. So see. Now over here they have said that in one step you can delete exactly one character in either string. So for example, let me take a variable which is at the starting index of this first string, and another variable which is at the starting index of the second string. So I have two choices, right? I have two choices that either I can remove this one or I can remove this. Now you might be thinking, why are you removing these? Why? Because they are not same. They are not same, right? For example, let's say if I had EAT and T, we have let's say ESA, something like this. So I will be here and J will be here on the starting index. So these two characters are not same, EE same. So obviously, since they are same, why to remove them, right? So then we will simply move our pointers forward. Okay. So every time we have two choices if they are not equal. If the characters which are, let's say this is your S1 string and this is your S2 string. So if character at S1 of I is not equal to character of S2j, right? If they are not equal, then we have two choices. Either we can remove the S1i character or we can remove the S2j character. Okay, because at one step we can only remove one character. So this is one approach, right? So here, what do you think? Whenever we have choices, right, we have choices, we use what? We use recursion. Meaning, we will try both the possibilities. It might happen that we get minimum answer from removing this one, or it might happen that we get minimum number of steps by removing this one. Okay, so now let's discuss the approach once. Let's dry run. You'll understand the approach along with dry run only. So I'll be taking this test case for dry run purpose because it will be more clear. It's a bigger test case. So S1 string is read code, okay, and S2 string is, what was it, E T C O. E T C O. So if you have done this problem earlier, longest common subsequence, then you will be easily able to relate this problem with that problem. Okay, but let's not go over there. We will solve it using recursion first. So see, we will take what we will do. We will take two variables, two pointers, one at the starting of this string, another at the starting of this string. So now I have two possibilities. Since this character L is not equal to E, right? So we have to either remove L or we have to either remove E. So what I will do, let's say I am removing this L. So what S1 will become? S1 will be, so initially let's say I am doing indexing. So initially I is at 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and this is 0, 1, 2, 3. I is initially at 0 index. J is also initially at 0 index. When I will remove this character, so I am just like when I say I am removing this character, it just means that I am moving this I pointer forward, right? So let's say we are removing this L character. So what will be the rest of the string? Rest of the string will be E E T C O D E. Okay. And we are not removing L. I'm just shifting. This will be one index only. So I'm just shifting the I variable to index one. Okay. So I will go here. Okay. So I will be here now. And this correct because I have removed this. So this will remain as such because we can only remove one character at a time, right? So the second string will be E T C O. So step, how many steps? We have removed one character, so step will be one. J will be here only. Now, in this what I have removed this L, right? But I also have a choice to remove this E. I can also remove E. So if I remove this E, what will happen? Deet code will remain as such, but this E will get removed, so this second string will become T C O. J will move one step, so J will be here. Okay, so this will be the second string. So I here, J here. Now over here, see, now we will check for this. So this E is equal to this E, that is S of I is equal to S of J. So there is no need to remove these, right? We can just simply move forward. So I will move forward when they are equal, right? I plus plus do J plus plus. Why to remove them if they are same, right? We just want to make two strings same. So if the characters are already same, why to remove them? So I will go forward. I will this string will be E T C O D E, and the second string will be T C O from here, right? Here will be I will be here, and J will be here. Okay, so I will now over here, if you see, let's see for this also. So over here, now again we have two choices because these L and T are not equal. So if I remove L, I'll get E E T C O D E, and second string will be T C O only. But if I remove this T, what I'll get? Deet code, and this T will get removed, so C O. Okay. So now let's go forward. Let's explore this one. So here we have two choices again because E and T are not same. So if I remove this E, I will get T C O D E. So I'm removing this, right? I'm removing this E. So a step will increase by one. So it will become two. Earlier step was one. And this T C O will remain as such. And if we remove this T, so what we will get? E T C O D will be remain as such, and this t will get removed, so it will be co. Okay. Now let's see forward. So here, now see, over here, what will happen? T and T are same. This is your I, this is your J, right? T and T are same. So we will not do anything, we will just move forward. So step will not increase, it will remain as such. Step is equal to 2 only. And CODE and CO. Okay. Now again see, over here, C and C are same, right? C and C are same. So again, we will just simply move forward. This will be ODE and this will remain O. Again, now these are same. So we'll move forward. This will be DE. And here, this O will be removed. So this will be empty string. So now see guys, whenever we get an empty string, right? Either of S1 or S2 becomes empty. It means these two are the extra characters which are not in S2 but in S1. Right? Do you agree on this? Whenever this second string will become empty, it means that these two are the extra, whatever is in the other string, these are the extra characters which are not in the other string. So if these are extra characters, we will return the count of these extra characters because we'll have to remove these. So how much it is? See, this is 2. So our step will become 2 plus 2, 4. Right? So this will be your minimum number of steps. So you can also explore further here. These other, you can just make this whole recursive tree. There you will better understand. Let's make for this one. So over here, see, if we this is E, this is T. These are not same. So if we remove this E, we will get E, T, C, O, D, E. Right? And this will be TCO as such. And if we remove this T, we will get EE, TCODE, and this will be CO. So guys, if you see now, this thing is same as this, right? ETCOD, ETCOD, TCO, TCO. So this means that there are repetitive subproblems, right? There are repetitive subproblems. So when there are repetitive subproblems, we can use what? Dynamic programming. Or you can use memoization, meaning same, memoization. How we can use it? We'll store the results which we'll get for this recursive call, and we will use that same result for when we are making this recursive call. We will not again make recursive tree for this. Basically, we'll not again do recursive calls for this. We'll just simply return the value which we got from here. Okay, so what basically we are doing is we are traversing both the strings S1 and S2, I, J. If the characters at both the strings are equal, we just ignore those two characters and we just move further. That is I++, J++. Otherwise, if they are not same, we make two recursive calls. In one in which we are removing SI, another which we are removing SJ. So if we are removing ith character, so I will be incremented. If we are removing jth character, J will be incremented. Okay. So I hope you understood the approach and the dry run. It will be more clear if you dry run yourself in just try to write the code. And once you have written your code, you can dry run on a test case. Okay. So see here what we are doing. Don't see this DP array first of all. Just see the recursive solution first. So here what we are doing, we are calling this helper function in which we are passing this word1 string and word2 string. And we are starting I and J initially from 0 index. So this is the I and J variable. Okay. So see. Now if either of the, if I has reached to the end of string 1 or J has reached to the end of string 2, meaning one of the strings, this condition means that one of the strings have become empty. So if one of the strings are empty, we will return the characters which are present in the non-empty string. So this is for that. Okay. If both are empty, meaning they are same, right? If both are empty, they are same, because empty are same, right? So we will return 0, meaning there is no need to remove any character. So 0 steps. Otherwise, if both the characters are same, we will make recursive call in which we will increment both I and J. But if they are not equal, then we will be removing one character, right? So 1, that's why we are adding 1, plus whatever the minimum value we will get from the either of the recursive call, because we need to find minimum steps, right? So minimum of I, when we remove s of I, so I will increment. If we remove j s to j, so j will increment. Okay, now we saw that there are repetitive recursive calls, right? There were repetitive recursive calls. So for that we have taken this dp, 2d dp, in which, because there were two variables, right, I and j, which were changing. So this, since there were two variables, we have taken 2d vector, in which we are storing the value which we get for ij. If the ij value is not initially initialized, I have initialized it with 1000. So if the value at dp of I of j is not 1000, meaning we have already calculated for that, because we are storing here. See, whatever we get, right, we store in the dp vector. So if the value is not 1000, means we have already calculated that value for ij. So we'll just simply return that. So this is for making less recursive calls, right? This is your memoization. So I hope you understood the problem and the approach. What will be the time complexity? It will be m into n, where m is the size of s1 and n is the size of s2. Because why this m into n? Because there will be m into n recursive calls, right? This many times the recursive calls will be there, because there will be no repetitive calls, right? So I hope you, and the space complexity also will be m into n, because we are taking this vector, right? So I hope this problem was clear. Let me know in the comments if you have any doubt. If you found the video helpful, please like it, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.